kind of begin, right? Good morning to everyone, right? As you all know, we have two visiting professors, right, from Ataturk University. The one standing is Prof. Sezai, and the one sitting down here is Prof. Eftan, right? The session today is going to be informal, right? And Prof. Sezai, the group that I brought here are our upcoming lecturers. Okay. They are the youngest in the hierarchy. And they are the most energetic. But we also have very senior person who is highly energetic, Dr. Howard.
I know.
You know? So the group that you have here are the most eager, willing to learn, and I think they are really looking forward to collaboration. Right? So I think a discussion after your talk will be wonderful.
Okay.
Give me 2 minutes to introduce you and Prof. Eftan, very short introduction. Okay. Because I will be tired if I introduce you. Your the CV and the merits are just too long for me to actually introduce. But I think the very critical one, in fact, before all this, right, I googled him. This year, in 2022, when I googled, he had 34 journals published already. So I told myself, oh my God, what am I, you know, looking at? But yesterday when I was talking to him, he said, Uma, you are wrong. I have 70 papers published this year alone, 2022, and you've just completed May. I googled you as well, and I know he has got teens, 18, 20s of paper as well. So my point is, we are all struggling to publish, right?
Yeah.
And here there are two esteemed professors who has the secret on how to publish, right? So please try to get that secret out of them. Yeah. And that's what this whole thing is about. How do you actually write something in a scientific journal and make sure that it's accepted, right? So I guess with that, Prof. Sezai, you can both introduce yourself and go ahead, right?
Thank you very much.
All yours.
Okay, first of all, we are so happy to be here because maybe this is the 10th time I was in Malaysia. I am frequently coming to Malaysia. And maybe Eftan is second time.
Yeah.
So sometimes I am coming to here as a tourist reason. I'm starting from Penang to Langkawi, then going to Sarawak and Sabah, Kota Kinabalu. So searching, this is touristic visit, but I'm searching the plants as well. So this is a mix. I was in Cameron Island, Champing Island several times. So I like Malaysia and Malaysian people. shortly, I'm Sezai Ersiz. I'm from Turkey. I'm editor-in-chief of some kind of journals. My expertise area is plant biotechnology. But I have another means. I'm expert on the publication because I am the member of EASA. EASA means European Association of Scientific Editors Association. I am one of the vice of this organization. It is a big organization, EASA. If you visit this webpage of EASA, you can take lots of information about publication. I can send you my list. So we have lots of webinars last year about the publication. This is one of my expertise area. I have interest to how can we publish the paper. Even my English is not good. It is not a problem. So it is not limitation. Just to understand the philosophy. So the other things is from our department, from vegetable science. He's also, I'm head of department. He's as an academic person in our department. He's very successful in vegetable science. So we are coming here for Erasmus Mundus programs for 1 week. So this is a good chance for us to present this topic. So I hope if you listen very deeply, you can understand the philosophy. So, and I'm sure that after these meetings we will make collaboration. So because we have very good network in the world, now you will see everything is changing in the application world. Now the type of the outdoors is changed. So you can forget everything. So the new world is established. So I will tell you what can we do. So otherwise we will be stopped, you know. So if you see I can start, so we can change. So this is my CV, because the CV is also changed. You don't need to write to CV, because people's going to Web of Science and write your names and your university or city and get information. Because this is not random. This is arranged very mentioned. So that means we can use each one for make some comparison. I will show you. For example, this is the number of publications in Web of Science. This is cited articles. This is time cited. And this is very, very important. Average per item. Very important, because we can compare to countries in terms of if your average is over the best countries, that means you are the best scientist. It is so important. So this is hash index. You know, hash index is also an important criteria to compare the scientists. So if people ask my CV, this is the my CV. I don't have another CV. So you can extract lots of things from here. Because I will show you one slide about citation per item in the countries. Turkey average is 3. Maybe Malaysia is also 3. But Denmark is 40. But if I over the 40, that means I'm better than Denmark. So this is also very, very important criteria. So if we talk about scientific indicators, we should consider economic indicators, because is very close to each other. For example, Turkey is, in terms of economic indication, GPD, you know, per income per person, we are sometimes 17, sometimes 90. So fluctuation year to year, but close to fluctuation. And you can see scientific indicators the same. That means 1790 is very, very close. If we consider Malaysia, I looked at the Malaysia yesterday, and it's like this. So you can see this is the economic indicators, 36, 39, and scientific indicators, the number of public. citation something like this, this there is a very strong correlation. But this correlation could be broken in coming years, because some countries pay article processing charge, but some countries not. Even in some countries, public universities does not pay, but private universities pay. This is also making problem. So there is a China effect, I will tell you. So this can be changed according to the open access, because maybe a couple of years, all of the journals will be open access, so you have to pay. But if the country does not pay, you will be stopped. So that is the big problem. So Malaysia, Turkey must rethink this. Otherwise, we will be late and stopped. So this is very important. So how can solve this problem? We have to find network. Some countries easily pay. So this is inevitable. This is the new era. So we have to be established network. Otherwise, we cannot publish our papers easily. So this is the facts. So this is the scientific publication performance in the world. You can see basic science is the first one. For example, physics, biology, botany, chemistry, you know, they are occupied in all universities. So they are the first. The medicine is second, engineering, and social science. You can see social science make publication very, very difficult. So we are lucky. If we are in social science, we cannot talk about the scientific publications. They don't interest in Web of Science or SSCI journals. They don't care. So you can see agriculture is around 3%, rather than pharmacy and veterinary and dentistry. So as agriculture, we are the in general quite the position in the world. So that means the agriculture is important, because in the food security in last year, the food prices is increasing in the world. That means the application related to agriculture will be increased. It is this is my estimation, but it will be real. So each country increased the publication number. This is very clear. This is the figure of Turkey, but if I prepare for Malaysia, it is the same. Because each year, the number of academicians is increased. And also, there is a promotion from the universities, all universities, for publication. So they promote to make publication. So the number of the publications is increased each year or in each countries. So this is the publication of Turkey, the number of publication. This is the same if we prepare the Malaysia, the publication is normal. So this is sorry I didn't prepare for Malaysia because I don't have time yesterday. But it is easy. You can meet this time. But you can see clearly in the world, basic science is the first. Each country is basic science is the first. It is very clear. So medicine is second. You will see that this is the, not I make mistake. And engineering. I'm sorry. In Turkey, medicine is first. But the reason they are working with basic science. So in fact, basic science is the first. So this is not true for me. And pharmacy is same, rich in the world, and agriculture is also a little bit higher than world average. So that means if you prepare for Malaysia, I'm sure that you will see the same figure. So we are expecting to increase the number of publication in agriculture, but in the last years, in particular last decades, there is a connection between agriculture and pharmacy. So the number of publication is increase in both sides, because both sides making positive effort with each other to increase the number of publication. So I don't know the Malaysia because about the public universities. Public means government universities, private universities. I hope you have also seen, because we have the number of universities is increasing in the last 10 years in Turkey. Unbelievable. 10 years before, the number of universities around 90. But it increased. And there is a discussion in Turkey. Why we increase the number of universities? Everybody talking because the quality is decreasing. The new open universities is not good quality. But this is the, you know, this is the conversation. But we should 5,500 universities in the United States and 8,000 universities in India. And Germany is the same size in terms of population, very similar to Turkey. The number of universities is 1,700. So this discussion is nothing for me. So we have around 200 public universities in Turkey and about 40 private universities. So the publication is mostly coming from public universities because private university culture is new in Turkey. But now there is a program. Private universities pay much money for good scientists. So now there is a movement from public to private universities. And we have some publication. It is not low. It is comparable with private universities. What is mean? That means there is a hospitals. The hospitals not belongs to universities, belongs to government, Ministry of Health, and they are doctors making publication. Maybe in here, there is a same culture. Also, there's lots of agriculture organization, governmental organization in Turkey. So there are lots of agriculture engineers. They are making PhD, master in universities. So they are also making publication. So this is also another source of publication. And comparable to private sector. So maybe it will be good if you prepare the Malaysian facts. So you can find maybe different things rather than Turkey. So why should we publish our research results? Is it necessary? We can make research and put on the table. This is the easy way. Research, complete, and put on the table. Okay, I completed. Not completed. Because without publishing research results, your work is not considered complete. So you can think 0 point to 100 point. So you can start the project at the 0 point, and the final you have to reach 100 with publication. So if you think that, okay, I reached the 100 without publication, it's not complete. So we have to change our mind. The publication is the part of the project. It's not out of project. We have to publish. Before or later, it doesn't matter. But we have to publish. So there is a common sense now in the world. Every country says that, please publish your research results. Is it weak or strong? It doesn't matter. The most important things you should publish first. So making the results of the research understand, because you know you can make the research project is very big, and project report is maybe 300 page. But you can extract the paper 5 or 6 page. It is very good for to understand your results, your project. Otherwise, we have to read 300 page and without understanding. This is very, very important. Is that communication tool and global recognition? I'm a good sample for this because I'm getting lots of email every day, and I'm asking why you send to email to me, how you find to me, and they send them with your publication. This is very good way for communication tool. So you can be global player if you have papers. So the element of the prestige. So you can, people say, I have over 500 published papers. It's a good prestige. It's not too easy. Avoiding unnecessary experimental repetitions. This is very important because you have project, you finish the project and pop on the table without any publication. And another university in the Malaysia can make start the same project because there is no publication. So if you publish, so they can stop. Yes, there is a publication and we don't need to use the project, start the project. So measurement element of academic performance. Now in all courses there is a the this is very important academic performance. So compare people in same department, faculty level and university level. And all universities cut these results on the web page of university. So we have to be published. So institution, organization support the universities. If you publish papers, for example, our university, I was the vice rector in last 4 years. The last year I left this position because I'm in the science world. I don't want to related to official things. Our university now put a program. If you publish papers in Q1 or Q2 journals, they can pay money. Every month you can publish paper and deliver to the people in the rectorate buildings, then they can pay money. This is very good support, yeah. And academic incentive is also very important. So, in fact, I have experience over 30 years. I can say that each slide is the reflection of my experience. So, scientific writing is as important as scientific research. You have to be good at scientific research, but it is not enough. You have to be good at also in writing. Do not be ashamed. I cannot write, you can write. You have to discover yourself. It is very important. So self-confidence is very, very important for publication. But we have problem in because our mother language is not English. Maybe you are lucky. Malaysia is better than Turkey in terms of English because of the colonization, common word colonization. But you can see that insufficient training in the scientific writing. We have lots of training about project preparation, but we don't have any training about scientific writing. This is not very big lack of the information. But what is the reason for this? Because we have lack of the experts. We have experts on the prepare of the project proposal, but we don't have expert on the scientific writing. Maybe in Malaysia it's safe. In Turkey and Malaysia is safe. Even in the United States, I spent a couple of years in the United States. My advisor is one of the only best scientists in plant biotechnology. He's also very expert on the writing. And we discussed this topic 20 years ago. And he said that, yes, Cesar, in the United States, we also lack of the experts. That means you can speak English as a mother language, but it is not enough. This is another world. Yeah, you have to discover. So, I'm talking about project and the publication because it is strongly belongs to each other. You must project, you must papers, publications. So it is, let's say, other words you can say, I have one week, another is nothing. So you have to One is project, another one is application. So this chart is very important because at the end of the project, you have to help scientific papers, citations, proceedings, international meetings, national meetings, plenary lecture about projects, awards, project awards, patents, product license, beautiful models, patents or beautiful models. You know, in social science, beautiful models is more common. And scientific events, training, workshops, and new projects. So, if you prepare one project, you should think about this chart. So, here you have to complete all of them. Maybe you don't have any patents, okay, no worry. Or useful models, or but at least you must have scientific papers. And maybe in coming years in citations. So this is very important. So all of these strongly belongs to project. So you should think project is not alone. There is lots of branch. So another thing, the publication is very important for the new project application. Because now the people, if you submit proposal, they are looking at your background. What did you do in the past? The very important criteria. Publishing papers from project is the most important success sign of the project. So this is inevitable. We have to publish the papers from the project. So project publication dissemination is very important. We must disseminate because there is a theory and practice. If the theory is not going to practice, it is nothing. This is very important. So, in fact, this is the big question because all of the countries in the world, there is a discussion. Scientist is working for himself or herself. This is not true. You are making publication, lots of publication, or Professor Sezai making publication for himself to get money from the university. This is not true. Because if you look at the chart, you have publication. For example, Journal of Agriculture and Food Chemistry. Yes, your name's on the paper, Sezai Ersisti. This is a personal success. But on the other hand, in the paper, your institution name, Atatürk University, is also writing. So how can we say this is the publication of Sezai Ersisti? This belongs to Atatürk University. Even which country? Turkey. So your publication contributes not only your personal success, but also institutional and national success. Because you remember the first slides, the countries is, you know, making classification in terms of number of publication. So your publication going to increase the country publication number. So this is not true. The people is making publication for himself or herself. will not do. So we should forget it. So I told you about citation per publication. This is European Union. We have the list. You can see Denmark. This is not really. The Netherlands, Scotland, Turkey is one of the worst positions, and Romania. I'm sorry, I didn't change the Romania as a English. So there is a big gap between. But you remember my citation per publication is over 40. So my efforts increase the country's efforts. It's very important. Otherwise, I want to improve this one. So I'm working for my country. Yes, for all humanity is but important. So we should think the reason what is happening. Maybe Malaysia is around 4 or 5. This is my expectation. What is the reason? So you can see the classification of the European countries. There is a 3 leagues, first league, second and third. I'm so sorry that Turkey is third. But the first league, United Kingdom, Germany, French and Italy. It is normal because the four countries is, in terms of economic development criteria, is one of the first countries. So it means they have strong support from the government for research and development. Only this, not only this. There is another fact. So another fact is next slide. You can see establishment of the university. This is the first university in Turkey. You can see there is a nearly 1,000 years. So there is a big gap. So university culture is very, very old in Bologna University, Paris University, Oxford. How we can compare our university with this university? Because the culture is very old. But alhamdulillah, the Muslim countries like Malaysia, Turkey, and Pakistan is very effective. We are closing the gap in a short time. So we should think this is very important fact. So in Turkey, paradigm change. This is very important year, 2002. Because before 2002, because associated professor is a very important level in Turkey. So this is, the exam is done by higher education council without universities. So to apply to be associate professor, before 2002, you don't need publication in Web of Science. But government decided this year you have to publish papers in Web of Science. So after this year, everything is changed in Turkey. 90% of the scientists in Turkey did not know about the means of Web of Science before this year. So everything changed in that year. So SCI or SSCI publication is obligatory to apply associate Professor Bekley in Higher Education Council in Turkey. So, after that, everything has changed. So, how we can publish our results in high quality journals? Maybe this is more, I don't have secret, but maybe you can find when I talk.
But I see everybody suddenly wake up with that slide.
Yeah.
Everybody move their chairs. So.
Yeah. So what is the mean general acceptance conditions? I can say that the evaluation for all of the journals is not objective. This is true. I can say that the decision 50% is random. You have very good papers you are submitting to, for example, Science and Horticulture. Because I was one of the editors of Science and Horticulture. They works as a random, exactly random. So you have very good papers, but your friends has very weak papers. You can see, oh, weak papers is published. What's happening? But this is the world. We should consider the selective journals. If you select the random journals, you have a chance. If you have weak papers, okay? So, but in general, all of the journals consider original value. What is mean original value? It must be new, different, and fill in the blank. This is one of the most important things, fill in the blank. So, when you prepare a project, you should think, how can I fill in the blank? Because if you decided in the project stage, in the publication it is very easy. Because you have to be quick to publish. Otherwise, another people's make fill in the blank. So, timing and up to date. Every 6 months, everything has changed. So all analysis or measures, there's a new sophisticated measure, new statistical programs. So everything changed. So we have to adjust ourselves within the changing world. Level of the interest of readers. Importance of the completions and recommendations, contribution to the journal. So that means you have to select correct journal. You have to type, and maybe one day you don't need to send papers to random journals. This is very important. A high score on the criteria increase the change of the acceptance of that. So this is your combo. You can make pick. Okay, you have paper and look at the paper and say that this is in terms of original value. You can look at, oh, my paper is new. Okay, different. In the blank, and we can make it. I'm sure. Go to second one, timing and up to date. Okay, my paper is up to date. Level of the interest of readers. yes, Hatem said yes, that importance of the confessions and recommendations and contribution to the journal must be matched. I will show you some slides. Your topics and journal's topics must be matched. Very important. So if you say that this is no negative, you are not reading. Forget this publication. Okay? So this is Turkish, I am so sorry. If you read it, you are in the dead side. You are reading new, original, up to date, but it is not up to date, not original. You are not reading, so you are on the I saw you focus this paper. So the most important things, firstly, you must evaluate the paper yourself before submitting. Forget everything. Take the paper, spend one day at the office or at the home and think the only paper. Ask the question, is it ready or not? Ready or not? Ready or not? Then you can submit. So, you know, there is a three types of the manuscript, full paper, short communication and review. Mostly 99% is we are related to full paper. Okay, how we can determine research topic? You see, everything belongs to project. So we are coming from project to paper. So you don't think papers alone. So you should make connection with project every minute. So topic should be up to date, important and attractive. That means new. Must be workable with technical possibilities. You have laboratories, but you don't have such kind of machines or so it is not possible to continue. Shouldn't be too broad. You can, in the project, you can select several topics. It is not possible to be successful. Only concentrate one topic. And potential for new research to be carried out in the following years. That means who can use your results in the future project, and it should offer innovation in the chosen topic, because we are in the innovation world, so we should use every time this is the innovative study. So the last 150 years we are using IMRAD system because before 150 years the scientific papers like newspaper, news, okay, you can write normal things, but everything is changed after last 150 years. IMRAD means introduction, material and methods, results and discussion. So it is obligatory to prepare the paper according to IMRAD acronym. Why it is important to publish papers in international indexed journals? Because you can publish paper in local journals, particular agriculture faculty journals or some another local journals. It is no sense, because these papers published in the local journals is not give the sense of the international audience. So our task is to publish paper in international indexed journals. So because it is important for international recognition, because if you publish paper in your faculty journals in your language, nobody can reach the paper. It's not important. Forget it. So individual, institutional and national, I showed you the figure. Competitiveness is very important. This is social balance. This is very, very important. For example, there is a discussion on the GMO plants or crops. GMO is useful or dangerous? How can we make sure? Or there is a discussion about herbal tea. Somebody says herbal tea is useful. So somebody says it's not useful. So we dispel social doubts, we need papers. If we have papers, we can show that, oh, GMO plant is dangerous. Because there is a clinical investigation. Otherwise, we cannot talk about this. So it's very important to make international papers, in particular about this whole social doubts. So each section, how we can prepare good papers, this is very important. Each section has its own characteristics. That means you don't think the totally paper. There is a section, but each section is the one paper. So please do not try to prepare paper, full paper in one day. I can sit 24 hours, I can start to write from abstract to completion. It's not logical. It is not possible. One day you can write introduction. Another day you can prepare materials and methods. Another days you can prepare results and discussion or results and discussion. And finally, you can prepare completion. My offer, the last is the abstract. When you finish the paper, then back to abstract. So think about each section is the one paper to be success. So remember Imran, okay? So what can we put good title on the paper? What is the secret for this? The one is the most attractive part of paper, because the people's first, they look at the title. It must be short, attractive, and should evoke the name of the journal. This is very important. If you work in molecular characterization of, for example, rambutan fruits, you should, if you want to submit Journal of Genetics, you don't need to use molecular characteristics. So you can use in the title genetic diversity or genetic relationship. So that means genetic names of the journal must be much of the title. Then both journal and title must be in the same, because it affects the editor-in-chief. When editor-in-chief look at the title, oh, the genesis, my journal. So, be careful. Do not use abbreviation in the title. Do not be technical. This is very important. Do not include keywords in the title. Do not include keywords in the title. So this is the sum of the secret to create a good title. So all the tips, there is a different types of orders. For example, what is mean corresponding order? It means owner of the paper. But in last 2 years, there is two, maybe in one paper, two corresponding order. It's possible. No problem. No problem. Ghost order. What is mean? They work on the project, but the project people prepare the paper and forgot his or her name. It is so this is not good for this ghost order. We can say ghost order. Co-authors, that all names included in the study, in the project, there's a one project leader, maybe cross-bending author, and the others are co-authors, and awarded author. That means it is out of the project, and somebody added on the author list. It's very common. So awarded order. But now, in changing court, this is very important. Intellectual authorship. This is a new, very new word. What is mean? That means, for example, Professor Hava has a big experience on the topic. He can prepare paper and sent to Professor Hava. She is not included in the project. It doesn't matter. So we can ask from her, can you read and correct the paper? So that means intellectual authorship. This is, we cannot say this is non-ethical. No problem, because she has over maybe 30 years experience. That means intellectual knowledge. So she can use her brain to increase or to improve the quality of the paper. So this is new, very new piece in the scientific world. And first name on the paper, you can say the most important person in the project. So, how about intellectual authorships? I told you before, because if you go to author contribution, you can see, for example, writing, review, and editing of the paper. So now all of the journals accept intellectual authorship. No problem. Okay? Do not worry about this. So somebody can add your names if you read a paper, correct paper. You can be right for authorship. We can take 5 minutes or 10 minutes. then we can start, because we are going to
start
out.
Yeah. Okay.
But I'm not sure if you're useful for you. This.
I think so. For me, it's useful.
It's always useful.
Yeah.
There are always new things.
We do have some sandwich and water. If you all want to grab one, please. Not sure how many of you all had breakfast. So. Can I get you one? Increase the number of analyses and increase the number of figures or tables, but concentrate only one topic. For example, if you're working on carotenoids, concentrate on carotenoids. But if you talk about yield, it's not related to carotenoids. You can make more detailed analysis of the fraction of carotenoids. So you can increase the number of tables. Maybe we can make some close topics to carotenoids and you can increase. But it is not good to different topics and to make one paper. Okay? Okay, now we start to prepare the paper. But as I told you before,
abstract must be last one to prepare. I'm talking the first one, do not confuse. Do not confuse, but it must be the last one. Clear and understandable abstract at value of your paper. The title is only important, I told you before. Abstract is also important because abstract means I don't need to read paper. If I read the abstract, I can understand. So abstract means you can remember Imrat, abstract including all parts of Imrat. Okay? One part from introduction, one part from materials method, one part from results, one part from discussion, one part from completion. So, if you have abstract, you can think Imrat, oh, it's including Imrat, perfect. But if it is not including Imrat, it is not abstract. Okay? So, the person wrote your article looks at the abstract. Just people want to look at your papers, they can first look at the abstract. The person who wants to get detailed information looks at the completion. So the two parts, completion and abstract, must be very different because we understand that the person, if you look at the abstract, must be learn all papers in the abstract, but want to get completion. Completion is the, you know, the next steps of the papers. So we should prepare. This is the problem because sometimes we can prepare abstract and completion the same way. When I read the abstract and completion the same, what is the differences? It must be big differences. Okay. So, what is the rules to prepare good abstract? According to journal rules, it must be between 100 to 200 words. Summarize the findings and their completions. Reflects the content of the article. Makes sense on its own content. Contains keywords. But abstract can include keywords, but the title is not. And does not include abbreviations, footnotes, and broken sentences. So that means if you have this, print out this one, cut the near the abstract, and make tick. Okay. 100 to 200 words is okay. Summarize the findings. Yes. Yes. Include all Imrat information. Reflects the content of the article. Yes. Makes sense on its own content. I'm sure. And contains keywords. Yes. It contains keywords. Does not include abbreviation, footnotes, and broken sentences. Yes. If you say, okay, you are ready. Your abstract is ready. And complete. So, we are going to second stage is introduction. Why introduction is important? Because if you send the paper to journal, the journal editor-in-chief look at the first, not the title, not abstract, look at the introduction. Because they can understand. If you prepared copy from the other papers or your knowledge, it is very easy for the editor-in-chief to understand. So, because the introduction is reflects the author's intellectual knowledge and mastery of the subject, it is very clear. If you copy from parts of parts from the and change the words to avoid the similarity ratio, the editor-in-chief can understand very easily. So it must be your own words. So it reflects your knowledge. Okay. So it should have a social spirit and also touch on social issues. This is very important because we are not considered this topic. But every topic we are working on has a background on the social arts. So think about social science, then talk on the social science. This is very important. Because, for example, if you work on the, for example, capsicum land race, it must be historical past and also cultural heritage. You have to add some sentences about the traditional use, cultural heritage. Otherwise, if you write without this, your paper is not good. So please concentrate on the social science, because the most successful scientists in the basic science, for example agriculture and chemistry, they have also successful in social science. Okay, so you can make a flat on the social science, because I'm writing poet many years. I have lots of books on the poet. That means I'm very successful on social science. So it reflects to the basic science. So there is a strong connection between two. So if I'm working on olive and I make analysis olive fruits, GCMS analysis, HBS analysis, but first I think the social. What is the cultural heritage? What is the olive? Because all of the olive books, it is the one of the fruits. So mention. So I have think this. It's very important. So I have to write some sentences about this. So make a general introduction and introduce the subject background. So that means please start with the general topics, general topics. For example, molecular characterization. Start to molecular characterization general, then introduce the research problem, what is the problem, and finish with propose and scope, context with the reader, tackle problems and solutions, cites to journals, propose and purpose. That means starts from general and going to special, your topic. But if you start the special topic, then going to general is the wrong way. So, if you print out these slides, and you can hit okay, and you can read it for the preparation. So introduction must be yes. Yeah, please. If you make the tick all of things, then again think. Take one cup of coffee. This is my habit. I'm taking one cup of coffee and thinking this one. The paper is making sense or no sense. If I say that, oh, says I no sense, forget it. But if you say yes, give the big sense, so it's okay. You should be happy.
Is it okay with all coffee or we need Turkish coffee?
It's up to you.
Turkish coffee will be stronger.
So now we are going to materials and methods. You know, each method must be clearly stated. We are making some mistakes for display the methods. For example, we can say Pauling methods, but we can forget the who found the Pauling methods. We can use another person. This is not good. Believe me that only this mistake the reason of the rejection. Yeah. Working area and material should be well defined. Please, where, you know, there is where, when, who, you know, there is a, Think about this. Current techniques and latest devices, brand of the equipment, something like this. And summarize then the data collection process. Then, where, how, why.
Can I request you?
Yes.
Nowadays, the journals ask similarity reports.
If
we clearly write the methods, some methods, some antioxidant methods,
yes.
Like that. So similarity reports gets high.
Yes.
So what should we do?
Yes, but we should change the sentences structure. It is easy.
But how can we write them?
It is possible.
Write the
different way. You have to different. For example, the first thing, if they write active sentences, you can make passive.
But we
change.
We save the same analysis 10 articles.
Yes, yes, yes.
20 articles.
Yes, this is, but this is not a big problem. But you know, you don't need to enlarge the methods. If you enlarge, the similarity ratio is increased. Shorten it. And change the sentences structure. Write different ways. It took time, I know, it is not good, but we must to do it. And also for whom? Why and for whom? We will make this study for whom? Who will we get benefit? Okay? Society or people or government. So you know this part is very important now, because if you make, I will show you one sample, my sample. If you make mistake in this area, your paper will be rejected. course, you have to use sophisticated model statistic analysis. For example, heat map. If you old-fashioned, forget the paper. You have to learn the new techniques, new analysis. Well, I have a good sample. Okay, maybe next slides. Okay, maybe. Yeah, look back, sir. We found it. Yeah. So you can see, this is our experiment. We work on the carob. Carob, Serotonin sepia, is a very common fruit in Mediterranean area. We have two type of carob. One is grafted, another one is ungrafted. So we would like to make samples long way on the Mediterranean parts of the Turkey, then compare grafted and ungrafted in terms of morphological, biochemical way. So I made this table. This is genotype number. This is the parameters. And I submitted this sample to the culture. And 1 week later, it was rejected without sending review process. Look at you cannot understand what is the means to take these tables. So when I took the rejection, I understand I made mistake. So I have to make PCA analysis, principal coordinate analysis. Because if you can make if you look at this one, you cannot discriminate genotypes each other. Difficult. Where is the grafted, where is the ungrafted? Because I have good hypothesis, because I think that the grafted samples has narrow biochemical differences, very narrow. But ungrafted, coming from seeds, there is a heterozygote and there is a large genetic diversity in all the biochemical content. This is my So I would like to test this hypothesis. This is very good hypothesis. But in this table, I cannot test this hypothesis. So I understand I made mistake. Then in SAS program, next one. In SAS program, I made this analysis. So you can see this is not maybe there is a problem on the screen, because I saw white is red one, grafted is blue. So if you look at, there is a large genetic diversity in white genotypes, and grafted materials is so my hypothesis is true, but without this one, the tables is nothing. So you have to use modern statistical techniques. So the image or figure must be more clear and must be more understandable. And you can look at next one. Now we have very good heat map. And for example, cast structure or something like this. So it is very, very easy. I have one assistant. I did not learn her these programs. I said that you have to learn. He tried 1 day and learned more. easy. Then so this is fantastic to show the so I went back to here because this is the results section. Only your own results. In the results section, only talk about your results. Sometimes we can make a mistake going to another way. He or she found something like this. It is not our problem. Write the results in different sentences. As I told Professor Ertan in the method section, in here also use different sentences. If you continue the same sentences, it is not good. So use shapes with modern statistic analysis to get higher visual impact, rather than tables. I showed you before. This is found higher than that. We are making mistakes every time. We found the results higher than the other studies, or lower. This is not science. We have to explain what is the reason, why high. Why? No. There is a altitude differences, genotype differences, soil differences, physiology, plant physiology. Okay?
Yeah, what are the statistical analysis softwares that are very, very popular or trending nowadays for communication?
HeatMap.
HeatMap.
Forget all things, HeatMap. HeatMap is perfect now. For if you work molecular, is mega program. I was using mega 4, but now there is mega 7, 8. Mega is perfect. So, you know, continue. So, use effective visual figures and tables. I can say that the Chinese people are perfect in that topic. I'm working with them. Last week we made a webinar to discuss some papers. They are very, very unbelievable. But this is very easy. And also people from Pakistan, very talented, also in Turkey. It is very, very easy. So, images are important for the intelligibility of the article. It should be short and contain comprehensive information. Necessary information should be obtained from here without reading the text. If I look at the image, it's good image, I don't need to read of the text. I don't need. I can extract information from the image. Okay. So, must not be excessive in an article. The Chinese people making mistake on this. They can use lots of image. It is also not good. So, we have now published papers in Frontiers in Plant Science with Chinese collaborator. Then you can see very nice images. So you cannot read the paper. Just concentrate on the image and you can understand what is the mean crosstalk between partition and Christianity or something like this. So it is very, very easy. Person correlation, you can understand very easily. Continue. So, is that fantastic? Then you don't need to read, write most of things. you can explain the one diagram, explain all things. It is fantastic area.
So, I'm going to now the discussion, discuss your results in terms of varieties, regions, countries. I mean, in variety level or cultural level, then go to region level, then go to country level. Smaller than bigger. Avoid the phrase on the table, discussion like introduction is a reflection of your intellectual structure and subject dominance. So we can understand in discussion and introduction about your knowledge. Is it your own sentences or stolen sentences? Any sentences? Okay. So firstly, you write your mother language. Okay. But think about social science. Then convert to English. And you can understand this is your speech. Okay, not to copy. From specific to general. You remember, in the introduction, you have to go from general to specified. But in discussion, controversy, specify to general. Okay? Do not forget. And conclusion, repetition of the research question and general summary of the findings, contribution to the relevant literature is included, must not exceed 1,000. But I can say that this part, this problem, even for United States, for UK peoples, this is very difficult part, very difficult part, not too easy, okay? But if you concentrate that, you can find the solution. What is the completion of my study? What can I do? This is a like a manifesto, small manifesto, okay? So that means first your mother language must be fluent. If your mother language you can speak very well, you can be successful. So I have a secret for you. Please read lots of books. Lots of books. You will see. You will cut the shortcut the road. If you read lots of books. Sometimes I can read two books in one time. One and two books. Yes, but it is necessary. So this is Turkish, but this is the introduction from general to specify and discussion, specify to general. Okay. So references. For me, is 30 is enough. 30 references is enough, not two. But it must be qualitative rather than quantitative. The reference must be very quality from the good publications. Careful. I don't want to say some journal names, but if you use the reference from, for example, African Journal of Biotechnology, forget it. One reference could be considered for rejection of your paper. So make sure you read and understand. The chief editor
or reveals can understand. You can use the reference, but you can read the paper and you can understand. They can discriminate very easily. But if you not read the paper but make the reference, it's not good. You have to read all paper. When you use 30 reference, that means you read 30 papers in detail. Okay? Then avoid referencing yourself and certain people. Do not give more literature from the same country and region. So open you to the world. West, East, South, North, because on the topic and publications that have been published in the recent years have been trained and reserved. Must be last 5 years. Now we are in 2022. You have to start 2017, not 2016. Okay. So it must be heavy paper on the area, heavy scientists on the topic. Okay. So do you know the Vancouver Forward APAS type, reference type, and also some arrangement programs, Mendeley and not and submission. You know this. You can. This is Turkish. I'm so sorry. I couldn't change last day. You can submit the papers going to first the journal, the pre-check, language check, and the shape check. Then go to the editor-in-chief. Editor-in-chief assigned one editor, and the editor sent to reviewers. This is the normal procedure. How can I find suitable journal? This is very important. The most of the scientists lost all the time to search the journal. But I have a, this is my suggestion. Please go to the Thomson Master Journalist. And if you work on foods, please write the foods. Then they can count the journal names and check if the journal is SCI journal or not. Okay. Also, you can use journals that refer to your previous publications on the site. In fact, this is for young generation. Not for me and Professor Hambar, because we can predict the journals. We have experience. So, but the young generation, you have to use this one. Okay? So, if you go to the Thomson journal list, you can find, for example, if you write nursing, there is a journal about nursing. And there is a one icon, coverage. And touch the coverage. If you touch the coverage, okay, and you can see, okay, this is Science Citation Index. This is the Web of Science and SCI journals. But also you can see there is indexed in the social science as well, because sometimes you can prepare one paper, you cannot decide it is okay basic science, but one part is social science. So you can find if the journal indexed by the SCI or not. You can see they are very easy. But it is
being familiar with journals is very important. Reading publication is relevant, good prediction to lost to time, to keep the time. You have to need good prediction. Scoop should be well read, full metro, party argument, not the journals. So how can the format the paper, the journal? You can look at the last issue of the journal, you can arrange, doesn't matter. So this is very important. There is a two kinds of letters. The cover letters, one is cover letter, the second is rebuttal letter. Cover letter means the first letter you are making submission is very important. Rebuttal letter means your answers to reviewers. Okay? So, please wait. Yeah. So in the cover letter, it is not good to write, this is my paper, it's original, please, something like this. You have to mention the importance of your work and it is relevance to the journal. In fact, this is the social science. What I mean, you have to think a little bit social science, okay? Make effect on the editor-in-chief. So, I'm going to finish. I have two slides. This is wrong way. I am taking lots of such a stupid cover letter from the authors. This is a few days ago I received this email as a cover letter. Dear editor, attach the paper. Please accept it, publish it, very important for me.
Very honest.
Yeah, yeah.
Very honest.
So, this is not good way. So, because it reflects your intelligence. And, okay, so you should be more social science. So, think about it. What is the level science? ISE. It was established in 1958 years by Egan Dunfield, but then bought by Thompson in 1992. Now we can say Thompson or Reuters. It's owner of the. Okay, this is very important. Please take the photo of this slide. Because why? We have to submit papers to SCI or SCI expanded. Two is same, do not worry. Expanded means not to enlargement. Okay, same. So, publishing in that journal is important in terms of the number of publication. Okay, I have over 500 publication in the was in SCI journals. So, what is worthy for the investigation? So, importance of the ISA Web of Science, give the information. What is the worthy investigation? It's very important. You cannot found this one the other sources. Second, what is important to the scientific community? What scientific community is working on? Which topics? It's very important. And it is also important in terms of the global analysis. So it's very important. For example, a few years ago, omics is not on. Yeah, yeah. I forgot the English name, but now lots of omics papers. So it gives two sense. You have to work on omics because it is important for the scientific community. Metabolomics.
Proteomics.
Yeah. Yeah. So it is the area we have to work. This is what is meaning peptide. You know, I can explain if you want. And publication should be multidisciplinary. This is now very important. If you repair one person, one paper, is it not so worth multidisciplinary? But is it national or international? Very important to be international. So that means you have to establish network from different countries because the reliability of the papers belongs to international authors now. Because the editor-in-chief can think that all of them check it. They are different culture, you know, and they put the value on the paper. And do not forget relating visual quality, in particular statistical analysis. So, journals observe regional balance. For example, I am the editor in chief of Turkey Journal of Agriculture and Forestry. I don't want to publish paper from Turkey or from Balkans. I need papers from Asia countries, also from Northern America, Southern America, and Africa. So that means I want to make the journals international audience. Sorry, one of that. This is one of the secrets. You can say not publish reports from the region. It's important. Same topic. Worked in different studies in different countries. But you can, this is the feeling gap. You can say, yes, there is lots of study in Northern America, Southern America, Asia, some. But there is no results from this region. So this is fill in the gap. In addition, you can think like a puzzle. You can say that without this report, the puzzle is not completed. Because to strength of the idea, we need more papers, okay? So you should increase the support, the hypothesis. For example, genetic diversity in national population. Is it true for example, mango in India, there is a high genetic diversity, but you can say, yes, there is a high genetic diversity manager as well. So this is the complete the puzzle. So strengthen the hypothesis. Okay? You must mention this one on the paper. So this is general evaluations. This is the topic solicited for the journal. You should make a tick and then decide. If your topic date, 1 year study or less occurrence, insufficient description of the material, incorrect statistical analysis, language deficiency, not being able to recognize the journal or magazine. So, for example, if you send the papers to Nature or something, you can get very kind email. Do you think? Submit paper. So this is the Nature journal. This is the Science journal. Okay, you have to know the size of the journals. So if you have big paper, if you submit to the chemistry, you will get the negative results. So be careful.
There is a lot of
train on this focus. But at the same time, there's the lack of the experts, not only in Turkey, in Malaysia, all over the world. This is the new area. So in Turkey, we are, I can arrange such kind of students, young generation, but I didn't find the expert. I invited the experts, they don't know the paper. They can say that I'm expert, but they talked about something different.
Actually, his graduate students are very lucky. Already, all of them have at least 10 SCI papers. We are inspired from you, also.
Inspired from you? Sure.
We are very lucky we have him.
Okay, so any another question?
The presentation very interesting because there's also a new injection of areas that over the time probably we overlook. You know? For example, the modern way of analyzing the data, which is very important. Yeah? So, well, we appreciate your your sharing with us. Coming back to the paper, how that's approached. I think it's a passion.
Yes,
it's a passion to write, but it does not start just with the passion. It starts with the research and the data collection itself. So this is an advice. If let's say the students is doing the work or any of the project, it's interesting actually, or it is helpful if you can try to read some of the journal papers that have some similarities. So as we are doing the project, we are actually putting the paper there. You know already the ideas of the paper, but it's a passion one, and definitely a lot of commitment on time. I think time is the one that is normally pulling us away from this kind of commitment. Because you know, you have to do that, you have to do this, you know. And writing means you sit down.
Yeah,
you're almost untouchable for a period of time. I think that's the thing. So I think for young mothers, I used to be young mothers before. Young mothers definitely is very, very challenging unless you have a good father around who's willing to look after the children. You know? I mean, this is always the thing. But if you have done your PhD, normally, well, when I did mine, my children were around 5, was the youngest. I lock myself in the room, of course the father's around, all right? Lock myself, don't disturb me, I'm working, and things like that. So that makes a lot of difference. But now that we go back you know, we have a family, sometimes it's unavoidable. But that's it. It's a very serious commitment. It doesn't come just like that. But to help you, possibly, is to prepare. You know, the paper itself, or the structure of the paper itself, can be prepared when you are, or the students are doing the work. From there, it's easier. In my way, normally, I do what I do. I look at the aspect of what I want to write in. I mean, this is a sharing session, yeah? It may be beneficial to you, it may not. But that's what I do. Then I start taking the set of data that, you know, has a focus that I'm going to talk about. Put the data all very clearly that I can see, all right? And from there, then you start putting the structure. That's how I do it, right? You're putting the structure, but of course, you have to have a lot of, you have to read a lot, as you say. You have to read real a lot. That one is unavoidable.
And Mr. Professor Ahmad, it was a very, very important, important speech, because to be academicians, good academicians, it is not a job, it is the life. So you have to live 24 hours with the
actually,
no
life because you sleep for 2 hours.
Yeah.
I thought he has more life because you only spent 2 hours to sleep. which side of the coin do you want to look at?
So, you forgot the job. This is not job. This is your life.
It's a hobby.
Yes.
I take it as a hobby.
Yeah.
Remember, I always say, take your job, make your job as your hobby. Once it's a hobby, there's no question.
Exactly.
But to get that into a hobby is something that you have to work on.
Yeah, yeah. But you have to know. It is a hobby. You have to go first, then concentrate. And there is no clear way, but you can find, maybe you can be better than us, exactly. But you have to think and concentrate, and you say to yourself, I'm scientist. It is my life. So it's so important. You can be another hobbies, but this is your life. This is not hobby.
This is hobby.
This is life.
I would like to rebut. Sometimes life can be miserable, but because it's a life, you can't do anything about it, you have to go on. Even though it's miserable. But if it's a hobby.
I am joking.
Yeah, I know. I no pain, no gain.
I'm just teasing you. I was just wondering, this is the problem that I'm having. I'm sure everybody's having as well, as a young lecturer. We get a bit overwhelmed with work, with students, with administration. I don't know how do you do all those publication being the head of department, and then you know we are given so many things. We are wearing like 5 to 7 hats at one time. So I'm having trouble to publish more because I couldn't find the time. But by the time I come back home, I'm very tired already. So how do you actually do you allocate like a research day or publication day? Do you do that? Any tips for us?
Okay.
Every day.
Yeah, but first you keep the time. You have, believe me, you have enough time.
Yeah.
So you use, for example, last night I had only 30 slides. So I was so tired. I couldn't sleep one day before because we have a jet lag. Yes, but I concentrate and I finish it in 1 hour. So it is possible because I believe that we have not limitation. So we can go higher of our limitation. Just from our heart, we have to believe our task. Okay, so we can be successful. Change, just change your daily things. Try to change. Yes, yes, yes. So the, for example, in my department, Ertan, Ertan is very effective person, working very hard. There is some person, they don't know the priority. They start the last things, most of the time. So we need to make the, what is the priority, then go to the best one. So we can be success. We have enough time. Believe me, sometimes I can look at the, my watch. I have 2 minutes. 2 minutes is
a lot.
Well, a lot, a lot.
Really?
Exactly. I like a lot. 2 minutes is a lot sometimes. So the God give to us
24 hours.
24 hours. So
I cannot sleep in hours. I can never do that. I'll be, you know, very.
No, no. I'm also not every, not every day.
Not every day.
Not, not possible. Otherwise, I am going to be a fossil. But the first you have to like. For example, I started first medicine faculty in Istanbul. But I think that I like agriculture. I can be more successful in agriculture. So it is up to you. Just discover yourself. The problem is we cannot discover ourselves. Please discover. Yes, yes, yes. And make it higher than your limit. Please push the limits.
Always challenge yourself.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So it is not too difficult. Not too difficult. But it must be the center. You should say that my task, I'm academician, is must be center of my life. Yeah. Center, this is the priority. But if you put some things in the center of the life, it is how it can be possible to be success. No possible.
Depends on your priorities.
Yeah, but the important is social. Read lots of books.
I'm sure with reading you